John Meacham, you and I are both sons of the South. I grew up, I was born in the suburbs of Atlanta, Georgia, and I know you were up in Chattanooga. I spent my summers with my grandmom in Dalton, Georgia, and throughout the 60s, as a little kid in the 60s and early 70s. And perhaps it's why Reverend Al and I are so taken by it, by what actually happened, that it's still hard to believe that the Deep South has elected its first black Democratic senator in the middle of the age of Trump, a Democrat in what used to be a deep red state. And Lester Maddox's state is, as a guy who wrote His Truth Is Marching On earlier this year, a bestseller about John Lewis's extraordinary life. Tell us, what's the historical import of this, especially after 4 years of the United States having a president that in many polls, the majority of Americans said, well, they knew their president was racist.
You know, the last time the pastor of Ebenezer Baptist Church affected a presidential election, affected the national conversation as decisively, was in October of 1960. So exactly 60 years ago, Martin Luther King Jr. had come over from Dexter Avenue to join his father as co-pastor of Ebenezer. He was trying to desegregate Rich's department store in downtown Atlanta, was arrested, was sent to Reidsville, the state penitentiary. Coretta King was terrified. She was pregnant at the time, that her husband wouldn't come back out. And word went up to the Democratic campaign for president, two brothers who were not known for their passion for civil rights, John Kennedy and Robert Kennedy, simply asking, would JFK call Mrs. King and express his concern? Kennedy, in a humane way, said, absolutely. Bobby found out about it and blew up and almost fired Harris Wofford and Sergeant Shriver, who had set this up, and then had a moment of conscience as himself and realized that King had been put away without bail. And so he calls the judge, which was probably totally improper, but he was doing the right thing. And Dr. King's father, Daddy King, said he had endorsed Nixon because he didn't like Roman Catholics. As JFK said, who knew Martin Luther King had a bigot for a father? Said that he had a suitcase full of votes and he was going to go dump them in Jack Kennedy's lap. And that moment in 1960, added to what happens in 64 and 65 and the 55-year journey since then, changed the South and changed America. Here's what's different and remarkable. This time, the pastor of Ebenezer is not at Reidsville. He's going to the United States Senate. And I think that it's hard to imagine, actually, a more vivid American 24 or 36 hours than what we're living through right now, when you think about it. So the black pastor of Ebenezer goes to the United States Senate. May well have a Jewish American United States senator going from Georgia. You have the Electoral College being counted in a process that came out of a controversy in 1801 when we passed the 12th Amendment because it's so messed up. So we have two centuries and a quarter of trying to acknowledge the peaceful transfer of power. And we have a demagogic president of the United States, exactly the kind of person the founders set up the system we have, which, however frustrating and difficult, is still the most enduring democratic experiment in the world. We have a president that they just did everything they could to prevent trying to incite violence in the streets of Washington. The best of us is on display, and the worst of us is on display. And that's the world that Joe Biden is going to be governing. It's the world that every president has to govern.
Thanks for checking out MSNBC on YouTube, and make sure you subscribe to stay up to date on the day's biggest stories. And you can click on any of the videos around us to watch more from Morning Joe and MSNBC. Thanks so much for watching.